like a 1-to-1 scale. Cause like seriously, like theoretically doing 700 miles an hour in a simulator game is kind of, I mean, I'm not saying it's a bad thing. I'm just saying, like, you should be able to set the scale. That would be nice. Ah, crap. Crap. Turning at a high speed. Hitting a non-existent bump. Oh, don't do this. Now we're playing spin tires. Just kidding. Oh, come on. Come on. How does one get stuck so easy? Go forward. Come on. Come on! Okay, wheels this way. Yes, yes, forget your car. I have important pressure tanks to deliver, lady. If I could straighten my truck out. What did I hit? Answer is nothing. And now I don't need a wheel. I think I wouldn't think I would really be comfortable with an actual wheel. I spend like an hour of my day, give or take, driving in the real world. So if I just wanted to sit behind the wheel, I'd just sit behind the wheel of my car. But if I want to drive erratically and be crazy, I feel much more comfortable with a remote or a controller. Then I feel like I have a different kind of feel. It's easier to separate fiction from reality. Turn signal! Excuse me, I'm turning here. The other way. Oh man, we were kind of losing. Losing a little bit of stuff there. Sugardew, thank you for following me on the stream here. Turn the signal is still on. See if I can crash into another car. What I should start doing. Every time I see that my phone's going off, or a new follower, I'm gonna run into a car. It's like head on. Not head on, because I can't jump that barrier, but butt to face. Which, apparently, somebody like warned half the country because there's just no cars on the road. Jeez, 500 miles an hour would be in like just off the wall. Can I like turn up the traffic? No, I can't turn the traffic up. I will not be able Just run into stuff. Willy-nilly. Here we go. I see a car. But that hill really slowed me down. Here we go. Watch the mirrors, everyone. Boom! Oh, we got airborne. I've definitely, like, between the two of you guys, I'm convinced I really need to start looking at all the different mods for this game. So I think I could probably have a little bit of fun with them. Oh, what the heck just happened there? I think I lost grip on one side of the truck. This is now a dual carriageway. Excuse me, sir. Excuse me. Am I on the shoulder or are you on the shoulder? Is that a parrot? Am I a parrot? Oh man. Speeding offense. Oh, just now, there's a speeding offense. Okay. Yeah, if you were hitting 500 miles an hour or more, and the truck was just ever so built just right, you would be flying. Why are the people stopped? It'd be very dangerous here. Don't try to drive faster than me, king of the road. King of the road. We're gonna go a reasonable speed. Oh, that's right. You're on UK time. Have a good night, FSX Gamer. Turn off my cruise control without knowing it. I'm just not paying attention to my lane. There. Definitely do not have. Oh, come on. Go tell the queen. Special delivery for the queen. Slalom. Damn it. This truck cannot do the slalom, which apparently used to be an actual test for cars. Like they still test cars by having them do a slalom because it's a good test for handling, but they would use it in the car ads. Like, this car can do the slalom much faster than our competitors. It's like, what does that matter? How well did it do, though? Because in a regular car, a consumer-level car, not a professional driver, not like a race car or anything like that, the main idea is for comfort and stuff like that. So it's basically the slalom. How comfortable was the slalom? Doesn't matter how fast it did it. It just matters how comfortable the ride was. In comparison to your mom. That's my windshield wipers. Miles. I get the feeling that means I'm going to be... Because I go a mile every 5 seconds. That's the scale. Like, I can be pulling 60. averages about a mile a minute in real world. And I'm going 12 times 60 miles an hour, which is roughly 700 and something. So, there's that. What I get for, like, scratching my eye for a second. My eye still itches. There we go. Lamo. Yeah, rammed into that penis-looking thing. That's what it looks like. Reasonable, ladies and gentlemen. That was a reasonable run. Am I level 5 yet? Yeah, level 5. All right. I am going to I've been playing for like 2 hours straight, I think. I don't even know. I'm just gonna take like a quick like 3 or 4 minute break. And I'll be right back. So yeah. BRBs. I don't like how some games is just like change the window and it's like, oh no, gonna stop doing the whole music thing. I don't get it. Oh well. All right. So I say, pressure tanks, ventilation shaft. I just want to do a ventilation shaft, except this pressure tank is 8,000 euro. So tempted to just do the 8,000 euro. It's from Liverpool to London, which is the reverse. Oh, you know what I didn't do? I'm dumb, I get it. You don't have to say anything, I get it. It's okay. How do I toggle off the tooltip for that? Okay, so, yeah, this is the road we just took. So there's that. There's that. That's not exactly too drilled for. There's that, which goes through Germany, which should be interesting. But it's a tractor. I don't know if that means it's like a tractor. What was the one that we just did? That seems kind of short. Like, it's just like this little bit here, and then you're on a boat for a bit. And then it's this bit. So I feel like we're gonna be doing some night driving. Yeah, let's just do this one. It's $8,000. Or, I'm sorry, 8,000 euro. Euro. Because euro is worth more than the US dollar at the moment. By like a factor of 0.5. Or so.
Dang it.
Okay. What am I driving? Why are my wipers on? Okay. Check my mirrors. Check my security badge. Oh man. Oh man. Oh man. I'm driving a man truck, man trucking. Hells yeah, let's get this show on the road. I got a full tank of gas and nowhere to go. Does this mean like I can do like off-roading stuff now? I got a man truck. I'm gonna obey no laws because I got a man truck. What are you doing? Just turn right. Except that's the wrong lane. There's your high beams. Oh, wow. High beams. That used to mean something. Oh, and it's raining. What's that button? And of course when it's raining, we do what? We turn off the high beams. Very good, children. next is Learn How to Drive with Kolin. Kolin Plays Games. With your mind. Trying to teach you how to drive. Shift up. Shift down, one of the two. Shift down. Move it over. I don't get it. Why does it have my turn memorized? As I was going through it. Who took this wall? I thought I had it on cruise control. Doesn't that also steer? This truck and I are just not having a good time. Man, I thought I would like a man truck, but apparently man trucks are weak.
This is Man Truck from Manchester.
Get up there. Come on. Get up there. There we go. Dead. Dead. Oh, I've had my headphones on this whole time. It must be a bit chilly. Dead.
Dead.
Should watch where I drive sometimes. Like, what crazy kind of, like, incline are we on that it's just chugging along? There we go. Now we're going downhill. Now we're hitting 60. Is that the beach? I'd love to go trucking by the beach. The wind in my mullet. The sand between my hat. I think it would be a great time. For me and my wife. Go down by the beach. I wonder if European truckers also have a, are like stereotypically like, I don't know what to call it, like southern, but southern isn't the same. Stereotypically like country. Why is there light below the bridge there? That's not how light works. It doesn't go through bridges. Unless it's Jeff Bridges. Oh, come on. This truck has, like, no... It's very unmanly, to say the least. Supposed to be a very cheap truck. It's like the Toyota Corolla of trucks. Not exactly pointful. Bridge. 144 miles. Speeding. Fine. I don't understand how I could possibly be speeding. I mean, granted, I'm doing like 60 and 50, but... Come on. 50 miles an hour on a 6-lane highway. Or interstate. Well, it's not an interstate. What do they call them? This is like the A41 or something like that. There we go, 80 miles an hour. That's your United States highway. It's maximum speed limit. Gonna hit 90. Oh, 85, 83, 82, 82, 83, 84, 84. Seven, because I went off road. 40, because zero, because I'm an idiot. Throw it into the. Good job, driver person. Going straight into me.
I didn't see you there.
Really? Are you sure? Did you have your headlights on? Did you? Were you looking at your cell phone while you were driving? Tell me these things. It's really the problem with driving on the roads these days. People are too distracted. That's how people get hurt. Either the people don't have the confidence to drive what they're driving in the conditions that they're in, or they're too distracted to be driving. That's how it is. At any given moment, I can tell you exactly what's going on with, you know, all of the vehicles around me. Not in this game, mind you. In reality, yes, I can. When I'm driving in my own car, I can tell you what all of the other vehicles are doing around me. Because I'm always paying attention. And that's when, of course, somebody pulls out straight in front of me, not paying attention. And then that gets me in trouble because I come up from behind them. Apparently that means I should have been in more control of my car. No, he should not be behind the wheel of a car. That's how it goes. Why is it? Yeah, like basically, like, why is. I have, like, weird theories with traffic law and crap not. Like, some of it makes sense, sure. All of it, like, there's a reason for everything. But some of it is, you know, it's just subjective. And how do you do this? And how do you do that? Like, I don't know. It's all a mess. Right, I'm driving with one hand. No. Okay. Shut it.
Okay, but that's not London.
Oh. Come on. Twice now, you've let me down. Wait, does that take me all the way back to where I... No! Jeezy, crazy. Oh. World map. Hey, look at there. Started in Liverpool. Okay, so I'm like, I'm halfway there. I'm almost to London. I am going to hit the quit button here. So I would like to play something else. I am, though, going to take another quick break. Just because I can. So I'll be right back. And when I come back, we're going to play a different game. What game is it going to be? I don't know. Do you know? I don't. Because, I mean, if you have a suggestion, I'd love to hear it. Like, really, like, if you have ever have a suggestion on a game, please, feel free to let us know. I'm going to have an email even set up for that sort of thing. So, yeah. The game that I was going to play, I think, I don't exactly feel like playing. Due to what time it is. Because currently, in my time zone, it is 11:25 p.m. Which is very late. So I will return in just a moment. Forthwith. Fifthwith. Sixthwith. I'm sorry. So, in case you didn't see it, we're gonna change one quick little thing. Let's die horribly. So we're gonna play either the Long Dark right now for at least a little bit, depending on how I feel. We might play a game with a similar title. Well, not so much, but with a similar premise. Loading. Yeah. Sandbox. We're gonna be a dude.
No lists of things to be done. The day providential to itself. The hour, there is no ladder. There is no later. This is later. All things of grace and beauty, such that no one hold them to one's heart, have a common provenance in pain. Their birth in grief and ashes.
Cormac McCarthy, The Road. The last part you have to say is a robot. It's how he wanted it. Yay! We're gonna die. Hi, Jeff. Sorry. I'm taking your Tinder plug? Are you sure? I don't like that I can store things in you. Am I in a cave? I am in a cave. Okay. I'm just trying to remember the layout. I've played this once before. This is an alpha game. It is available on Steam. It's called The Long Dark. It's basically a survival game, which means you have to survive. It's a very cool concept. It's basically you're trying to survive and everything, but you're pretty much surviving mostly against the environment. The environment is your enemy in the game. I'm just gonna go this way, because I don't know what's what. Yeah, like, you have basically two enemies. The elements and the sun. No, and a couple wolves. Wolves. With a V and a Z. Wolves. One wolf is one that roams around. You can hear I'm getting cold, see, and my cold bar is going up, which is bad. The more cold you have, the more cold you are. And I have found that running on ice is only good in that there's not a good chance that I'm gonna sprain my ankle. Okay, so there's Mystery Lake Knob, North Point. Okay. I feel like I have my bearings. Door number one. Cabin. Plastic container. Empty. That looks like something, seriously.
Beef I could jerky. Use this.
I know. Isn't that amazing? You could use that. Well, you know what? I just noticed that my chat window went away. And also that... this thing's a pain in the butt. Doo-doo! There we go. Okay. What? 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 I am so confused. There we go. And I lose my... now I'm cold. That's not the front. This is for some reason the front. Okay. We got a stool. Oh, shush. It's not that cold. It's only -1 degrees Celsius. So it's like 30 degrees. And suddenly, it's fog. The fog rolls in. The fog rolls in. Got the newspaper from about a week ago.
Looks like this has been here a while.
Looks like it has. Plastic container.
That'll come in handy.
No, it won't. That will. Next group of cabins. Are there no bodies out here? Out of curiosity, of course. Huh, I guess not. Okay. Sorry. Cabins number two. Dead guys. Oh. It's just stuff. Ooh, backpack. Backpack. I'm the backpack. I'm
hope
the backpack.
Nobody needs I'm this anymore.
I'm the backpack. I'm the backpack. Poor little kittens. They've lost their mittens. So the mama beat them in the face. These two things are just really dark. Quality ultra. Yes. Full screen, metric. Huh, there's no gamma or anything. Okay, that's fine. Back to game. Just have to squint a little harder. Yeah, a lot of like wood, like fire, building, product. Sorry, can't help it right now. All right, back outside. Back inside. But in another cabin. In another cabin. Fire log. Is that like a water log? But clearly the opposite. Metal box.
I could use this.
Good. For how? My mouse is just going funky. I think it is. At least I hope it is. Here we go. Back inside. Nothing under the bed. Got a backpack. Gonna look inside.
What have we here? Back.
We have water. You know, you ever heard of water? I make jokes, but this is a really awesome game. Like, for some reason, my mouse is all glitchy. Maybe it's something to do with the latest version? I'd hate for their sake that that's how it is. This is made by, like, a really, like, small group of people. Okay. On to the last one. And then we shall move to our base of operations. As we haven't been there yet. The lake cabins are pretty much the first place I go. And then I move on to what's called the camp office. Which is a two-story, basically a two-story house. Just on the other side of the lake. Which has a whole lot of storage area and has like a nice, well, it has a bed, it has two stoves in it. So if you had like a lot of enough like firewood, you could pretty much just have two fires going in both spots at the same time. Keep you warm for a long period of time, which is good because the temperature is currently negative 14 degrees centigrade. All right, get moving. How much am I weighed down? 19.5. Okay. So I have about 10 pounds to work with. Or 10 kilograms. I'm sorry. Kilograms to work with. Come on, no way.
That'll come in handy.
Mittens. I think the other mittens I have are in better condition. Cardboard matches. Those are terrible. Basic gloves. I think I'm wearing some. That didn't sound good. Frank! Why, Frank? You got the white stuff on your head. Frank! Grape soda! Got that purple drink! Down ski jacket. That's always is a mess with these kind of things. The condition, which is right there in yellow, 33%. Got some peaches or pineapples, whatever one it was. Probably peaches. Okay. You can see right there. I got my little dot on it. That's where we're headed. Home sweet home. To those who have played. Pretty much to most people who have played this game before. This is actually the camp office.
Hope nobody needs this anymore.
No, no one needs this. You're the only one out here. Dog food, that does not sound good. I do not want to eat dog food. I was actually just watching a YouTube video about a bunch of people just eating dog food. Like, they weren't like doing like, oh, that's the only thing I eat. No, they were like, no, eat this, it'll be funny, kind of thing. Crap. I'm used to M being map between this. Like, I play so much Warcraft. It's just like, I'm used to running and hitting the M button. Oh well. Are there any dead people around the house? The camp office, rather. Okay, well, let's or cold, so let's forge for wood. Forge for an hour. Unable to forge any wood. I'm freezing and I'm hungry.
I could eat anything right now.
Oh, shush. Insulated vest. I've never seen an insulated vest on this game before. Calories, negative. Whoa, I'm burning a lot of calories. Okay, let's put the food in my face. Grape soda, that'll give us some calories. And probably not. Not exactly sure if I wanted to do that, but it's worth a shot. How bad shape am I? Frack. Okay. I'll just eat some more porks and beans. This is 25%, which is a really bad idea, but 'please don't get food poisoning. Thank you. I'm not gonna risk that again. Okay, I totally am. Peaches, how bad could peaches get? You have food poisoning. Your party has died of dysentery. No! Jesus, it's like nothing fills me up. I'll tell you what, if I had two cans, of bacon and beans, which is just baked potato, or not baked potatoes, baked beans, here in America, in that case, then I would be pretty full, and I would be really farty. Like, really farty.
I could use this.
You could. That 82% even. Ooh, and another can opener. That's even better. Oh, cabinet. Summit soda. The soda for when you are on the summit of your death. Dun, dun, dun. Okay, nothing in here. This. Aw, oh, man. Josh.
What have we here?
A granola bar with Josh's smelly self on it. Wood matches. It's just like, it's eerie, the random placement of the music. Like, suddenly, music!
Looks like this has been here a while.
It doesn't sound like a good thing. These long johns look like they've been here for a while. They got, like, blood stains on them. This is my new thing. When someone sends me a text message where I'm being obvious about something I'm doing, I don't respond with words. I just take a picture and I send it to him. Because I feel like that's more of a jerky thing to do.
Hope nobody needs this anymore.
No, because everyone's dead. Painkillers.
He is the painkiller. This is the painkiller.
Okay, so I'm just mainly hungry, and I'm being weighed down by porque fire logs. Okay, so let's dump all of the firewood in here. Dump it. Now, we actually should probably go through the rest of this. Not good things. Okay, so this is at 64%. This one's at 21%. Probably not gonna wear that one. We will wear this one. Warmer! Yay! Work boots, 94%. Heck yeah! Bedroll, can't exactly wear that. Go on. Wear thin wool sweater or thin wool sweater or thin wool sweater. Long wool underwear. Cotton long underwear. It's 1.5 versus 0.9. We're gonna wear the wool ones. It's a whole percent difference. I don't know why, but I'm just gonna go with it. Basic gloves. No. Basic wool scarf. Yes. Can opener times 2, flare, jeez. Mittens? Kittens. Okay, we're gonna wear these mittens, because those warm you up a little bit more. Toque, I'm wearing my toque. Wool socks. These are better wool socks. Because the rest of them, I can just kind of... I can harvest them. Wait, go back. Here, this one. The reclaimed wood, all of it, transfer all. Newspaper print, transfer all. Cedar firewood. Wait, I just saw their tinder plug, there we go. Sorry, I'm like having a serious conversation with one of my counterparts. Basically, it's an ex is kind of dragging him down, which isn't necessarily fun, but in the end, it doesn't really matter. Shoot, I was just wearing that, wasn't I? No, I wasn't. Was I? No. Oh, sweet. Pins. Ooh, socks. Ooh, socks. Awesome. There we go. Now I'm down to 14.4 kilograms. Pretty much just like, you know. Blaming themselves for something to do with their ex, and you can't do that. It's not, no matter, like, it's a tough thing with relationships, and I can go on a tangent for hours and hours when it comes to that stuff, but I'm gonna try not to. Crap, there's a wolf nearby. Where is he? Alright, I'm gonna go inside. I'm going to hit quit, because it is currently 12:05 p.m. which means it is past my bedtime. So that's all for tonight for Kolin Plays Games. I'd like to believe that I'll be around tomorrow to be able to play in some more games. Probably, if I do play anything tomorrow, it will be World of Warcraft, at least a little bit. I do try to get my fill of World of Warcraft. Every so often. In the meantime, don't forget to follow us on Twitter, @OTBeards. I do have to emphasize the OT instead of Attack of the Beards all one word, because Twitter's character limit and blah 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 with the usernames and stuff like that. Facebook, you can go onto Facebook and just search for Attack of the Beards. Like the only one there. I'm pretty sure it's facebook.com/attackofthebeards. I could be wrong. I can't remember. Also, you can just go to attackofthebeards.com. Pretty much where you can find links to everything and follow us along there, as it's connected to Tumblr and stuff like that. And of course, if you're watching this on YouTube, or if you're watching this on Twitch and you would like to subscribe to our YouTube channel, because not all of the replays are going to be on Twitch, because Twitch is getting rid of them very actively now. But you can go over to youtube.com/attackofthebeards or Attack of the Beards, which is on YouTube. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I'll see you guys tomorrow. And I do want to just give a quick shout out to those who's not subscribed but followed today. That gets us closer to being able to have subscribers on the Twitch channel, which definitely would help us out doing more stuff, like have some fun with you guys, the viewers. Anyway, I'm getting kind of tired and I need to drink more water. So, good night, have a great tomorrow. If I don't see you, then see. Yeah. See ya.